and gals. My name is Doug Wilson, and this is Yellowhawk Customs Outdoors. There's the age-old conundrum of how guys and girls like to carry their knives. In which material? Would it be leather? Or would it be kydex? Those are basically your two options. There are other more traditional, like wood and things like that. But if you guys stay tuned, we're going to explore leather versus kydex, and I'll give you my opinions. Please stay tuned. Okay, so honestly, I really want to do a live feed about this subject, leather versus kydex, and I know how controversial this issue can be among outdoorsmen, especially on YouTube. And, you know, I really don't like to get into that controversy stuff. I'm pretty frank. I tell it like it is. I do sometimes tend to, you know, ruffle people's feathers. It is not intentional. It's just that I know what I know. And what I know is based on experience. I don't bullshit anybody on these videos. If I say I did it, I did it. Okay? That's all there is to it. I don't know how else to explain it. But in the end, if you don't respect my opinion, don't watch the videos, right? I do get comments every so often where a guy will rebuff something I've said. Well, that's okay. It's your opinion. I just stated my opinion. That's all they are. They're just opinions, right? If you can garner something from the video, please do so. If not, then it's okay. You can garner information somewhere else. All right. So, leather versus kydex. Leather versus thermoplastic. I haven't always called it kydex. When I first started messing with this stuff, I just called it thermoplastic, right? Because that's the name it was, you know. And then kydex became a company and a trademark, and now it's referred to as, all of it is kydex, right? All thermoplastic sheath material people are calling kydex. But it has different names. Holstex, there's other companies out there that make kydex-like material that works the same, you know, for making sheaths. I mean, they mold car parts out of it, body parts, stuff like that. Okay, so, do I like leather? You bet your ass I like leather. I've been working with leather since I was a kid. I was a leather worker before I was a kydex worker. So, you're getting a person's opinion who comes from both worlds, right? At some point, I made the decision, 99% of my sheath systems are built with kydex, right? Here's the reason. Kydex is tougher than leather. It doesn't absorb wet water like leather does. It far outweighs leather in protection value, meaning protecting you from the knife and the knife from everybody else, right? Or everything else. It doesn't mold, it doesn't rot, it doesn't mildew, it doesn't dry rot. It's pretty much indestructible. It can be broken, especially in very frigid temperatures. You can crack kydex, but generally, even if you crack it, the sheath is still serviceable. It's just, leather is very practical. Kydex is very practical. Kydex is very practical. Did I say that? Okay. Anyway, especially with all the different patterns of kydex that I'm able to get my hands on now. There's leather-looking kydex, here's some. Like this sheath right here, this is called Raptor. It's got a leather finish, to it. And I tell you, you would swear this was leather before you picked it up. You would swear it. It looks just like leather. It doesn't act like leather, though. It's not soft. It's rigid, right? Now, one of the complaints I hear guys always spouting, right, is Kydex is noisy. Yeah, it's a little noisier than leather in most cases. However, you can get a silent draw with Kydex, and I'll show you. Okay, it's pretty silent. A deer who's 100 yards away isn't going to hear that. All right, you can even get a silent insertion if you're careful. You just push it until it seats. Okay, there was no click. It only clicks when you do that. I don't mind the click. I'm not a huge hunter, but when I have to be tactical and I have to get into that covert mindset, that's how I use my Kydex. Quietly. I use it quietly. And it can be used quietly. as far as it smacking up against stuff, leather does the same thing. You got, on dangler systems, you got metal rings and stuff, so the metals rot. See, they both, Kydex is a little noisier than leather, though. But, like I said, if you're careful, it's just, for me, Kydex far outweighs the benefits. The benefits far outweigh leather. Just my opinion, okay? I'll also show you this, all right? Now, I'm going to show you this because it happens. And it happens more than you think. I've probably had, 10 guys in the last year tell me they've done this to their sheaths. And they immediately then purchase a custom sheath from us, right? So if you take a look at this leather sheath, this is what happens to leather, okay? In the field, this happened in the field. The client took his knife, put it in the sheath, right? He just put it in the sheath. Ended up catching the leather and slicing a quarter of the way down the sheath. This sheath is no longer usable. Can't use it. That knife is definitely going to fall out of there now. Okay? The thumb strap with the snap on it. Let me take this knife out. The thumb strap is nearly, a quarter of the way cut through. Right? These are the kind of things that happen to leather. It dry rots. It gets wet. You can weatherproof them a little, but I don't care how much weatherproofing you put on it, the leather is still going to get wet. Okay? Take it from me. I've been working with this stuff for 40 years. Leather will get wet. I don't care what you do with it. Snow seal just slows down the process. That's what snow seal does. Leather treatments just slow the process down a little, make it water resistant, but it will get wet. And when it does, it gets heavy. Doesn't dry fast. If you have to put it next to a fire, then you risk ruining the leather completely, because it doesn't take much next to a fire to get this stuff to dry out, and then it rips real easy, dry rot, right? Leather sheaths can be more dangerous than Kydex sheaths as far as carrying capability and protecting you from the knife, right? I've had guys take a knife and run it right through the back of the sheath when you sheathe it into their leg. Now, it didn't cut my leg, but it did rip my pants. All I had to do was shove it a little bit more, and it would have went in my leg. I would have pierced my leg. I would have had to get stitches, go to the hospital, whatever, okay? Risk of infection, all that stuff. This is risk assessment stuff here, okay? This is a risky material for field use. It just is. If you choose to carry it, then you have to know its drawbacks. That's what this video is about. Leather does have drawbacks. Kydex has drawbacks. But leather can just be dangerous sometimes. And if you haven't heard the horror stories, I sure have, right? At least 10 in the last year have told me what they've done to leather with just putting their knife in, okay? Now, I have to reiterate, I still love leather. I love it. I carry this knife all the time. This is my Kellum Woodworker, right? And in my opinion, it belongs in the traditional leather sheath that it came in. The Puko style, I use it as a neck knife. It works great. It holds the knife well. All right? It's in there pretty snug. Plus, I keep it right side up on my neck, so it's never this way. If it was this way, and I was carrying it this way on a shoulder strap or whatever, it would definitely be in Kydex. If you turn your knife into an inverted position and hang it from your neck, it needs to be in Kydex. Leather is not going to cut it. Just my opinion. You might be able to rig up something that will cut it, but you're going to end up cutting it, right? Anyway, little pun there. I use this all the time. It's a great leather sheet. I have weatherproofed it with snow seal and oil, right? I use, if I have to oil a hide, and I don't really like doing it a lot, I'll put a light coat of Neat's Foot oil on it, and then immediately follow it with three or four coats of snow seal. Snow seal. S-N-O-S-E-A-L. Snow seal. Been using it forever. There are other products out there that may be as nice as snow seal. I don't know. I use snow seal because it works, and it works well. There it is. So I carry leather almost every day. So don't think I'm not a leather advocate, because I am. But it has its place. And 95% of the time, I want my knives in Kydex. It's that simple. And there's no one out there that's going to make me believe that leather is safer than Kydex to put a knife in. More practical than Kydex to put a knife in. More usable, more utilitarian, okay? That's what Kydex does. All these options that are on here, very difficult to get them on a leather sheath, right? Trust me, I've been a leather worker for a long time. The logistics of putting all this on a leather sheath is harder. It's just harder to do. It's less practical to put all this stuff on a leather sheath. Then it gets really heavy. When you double up the leather, it gets really heavy. Heavier than Kydex. Now, is it a big difference? No. Okay? But generally, they're about the same as far as weight is concerned. And I'm only talking about the Kydex and the leather. I'm not talking about what you put on it. If you take a leather sheath that's fairly lightweight and you strap a gigantic 5-inch by 6-inch half-inch by 6-inch ferro rod on it, it's going to start getting heavy. Now let's talk about utility. Leather versus Kydex. Utility-wise. You get a good sheath maker. Good sheath builder. Right? Who can do something like this. Right? And I tell you, honestly, I don't know anybody out there that does it like we do it. Right? 100% custom. To your liking. Whatever you want is what you get, if it'll work. I like to work with clients, and I ask you, hey, what are you looking for? What kind of options? What kind of carry system do you want with this thing? And you and I work together. If it takes us 3 days to come up with a system that's right for you, then it takes us 3 days. We text back and forth, or you call me, or whatever, right? It's all about communication when I'm building these things, because once it's finished, It's finished, and you're going to have it for a lifetime, or two, or three, or whatever. They last that long. They're that tough. They're that durable. I stand by them 600%. That's what you get when you buy a Yellow Hawk Customs Outdoors sheath system. You get that kind of retention 95% of the time. And if I can't give you that, I'll tell you why. It's probably due to the geometry of your particular knife. But I'll tell you what I can do for you. I may be able to give you a compression fit, which is pretty good. Pretty good. I do it pretty good. Okay, so my battery ran out. So I had to pop a new one in. Where were we? Utility. What you can actually put on a Kydex sheath. And how we do things here at Yellow Hawk. I know, because I get other sheath makers' sheaths come through our shop on a weekly basis. On a weekly basis. I get other Kydex sheath makers' sheaths coming through the shop on a weekly basis. I get them all the time, either to be replaced or repaired. I don't like repairing other makers' sheaths, because they don't do it like we do it. And I have to do what we do, right? So I do know this. We do a lot of stuff that other makers just don't do. And I could go into detail. I can't go into detail. But if you are a client of ours, you know. I hear it all the time. Doug, I thought Kydex was this before I got one of your sheaths. And now I know what Kydex can be. That kind of thing, right? Now, that is absolutely true. I get those comments all the time, right? I get accolades and promotions from guys, attaboys, every single day. And they really love our sheath systems because they're tough, they're durable, bomb-proof, utilitarian, well-made, high attention to detail. And I mean the highest. This sheath here, other makers are going to laugh at me. I'm telling you right now, when they find out how long it took me to make this entire sheath. And I build them. I don't just make them. I build sheath systems. It took me 14 hours to build this system right here. Now, this one is my personal system, but if this was for a client, you can bet your ass it would have taken me 14 hours to build it for you. That's why we're a little more expensive than other makers, because of all the time and attention we put into making everything absolutely right. There's no rattle. There's no play, right? Nothing to speak of. Now, in every Kydex sheath, you might have a teeny bit, right? That's just Kydex. That's what Kydex is, right? It's not exactly perfect, right? But it's as close to perfect as it's going to get because we spend so much time on it. I have a 13-week wait list for sheath systems, and I do this full time. And Zach, he does the eBay sheath systems. By the way, he's been sick for the last week. I just got over being sick. But we do this full time and we still have a 13-week wait list. I don't know any other maker that has that high a wait list. And that's a valid, like, my books are packed with sheath system orders from guys who, a lot of them already own Yellow Hawks, and they just won't own anything else. That's how dedicated they are to the brand. And I thank them for that. That keeps food on my family's table, keeps clothes on my back, their back, pays the rent, pays the car, you know, all that stuff, right? I used to be a tractor-trailer driver. I like this a lot more than I like doing that, so I do this now. This is my full-time job. I am a custom Kydex and leather over Kydex sheath maker, sheath builder. I like to say build because we don't only make Kydex sheaths, we build Kydex sheath systems. And they really are systems. And that's why I use that word. I had a guy make a comment the other day, oh, they're only sheaths. Well, not to me. Not with all the time we put into, you know, building these things. You know, a system to me is you got this component, 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 and these components down here, plus the overall as a system. All these components together as a system allow you to be more effective in the field where your knife can only do so much. Your knife pretty much can't build a fire on its own without that ferro rod and without that live fire. And you know what I'm saying? Yeah, you can bang it on a rock, but you need char material. It's just more utilitarian, right? It's a sheath system that's utilitarian. And it's as utilitarian as you want it to be because you guys are the boss. Other makers, I know how they do things. They generally, just generally, build sheaths that they want to build and then they sell them. We don't do it that way. We let you design the sheath with our help, and then you and I do it together so that you are assured that everything on this sheath is what you want it to be. That's how it works for us. And I'd go to the nth degree to make that happen. You can ask anybody what their experience is with Yellow Hawk Customs, and a lot of them will tell you the same thing. There's a lot of communication involved because this is an important piece of gear, at least to me it is. And if it's not to you, you can go have somebody else make you a Kydex sheath. I'd rather build them, right? To make them something substantial that's going to last you for the rest of your life and your kids' lives and their kids' lives, right? All quality materials, nothing cheap about what I do. Like I said, that's why we're a little more expensive than other makers, right? Because we build them, and we build them tough, and we build them out of quality materials. Trust me, there are differences in Kydex. There are differences in the way other makers do Kydex, right? A lot of them stick with thinner Kydex because it's cheaper, it's easier to work with. To me, it just doesn't build a strong enough sheath system. I go for the thickest I can get, which this Raptor right here, I measured it, is 095. Okay? Last month I had 096 in Raptor. Right? So I'm able to get it thicker, right? That's because that's what we require here. A bomb-proof. Look, it's no secret. I was in special ops. Everything in special ops has to be right. Has to be tough, bomb-proof, utilitarian. We had the best of the gear that the government had to offer. Plus, we even used civilian gear. In special ops, you can do that. Certain units have autonomy in the gear that they carry. We carried a lot of gear that wasn't on the TONE. You know, it wasn't on, it wasn't what the government said we had to carry. We carried a lot of civilian stuff because it's better gear in some cases, in a lot of cases, and it's lighter. So, I got a lot of experience with testing and using quality gear. So I know what mil-spec is. I know what military grade means, right? I know what bomb-proof means. And that's how we build these things. So, all right. So this video was leather versus Kydex. If you choose leather, more power to you. And there are some great sheath makers out there. Really great ones. I tried to say some of the names. Justin Wolf is the only one that really comes to mind right now for me. Don Gamber. Don Gamber. He makes nice leather. He doesn't only make sheaths, he makes pouches and all kinds of other stuff too. Donald Gamber. Gamber Leather Works, I would imagine it is. Like I said, I'm not really up on the leather guys out there. I think their stuff is beautiful when they show it, right? It's beautiful, it's utilitarian, it works. But when you need something that's a cut above, I'm a Kydex guy. It's a cut above leather, in my opinion. It's stronger than leather. When you put this, even if you jam it in there sideways, you're likely not going to cut through the Kydex. Even if you put a slice mark in it, it's, you know, a thousandth of an inch deep. This is tough shit, right? Now, if you go and jam that thing in there, you might be able to cut it, you know, an eighth of an inch or whatever. But it's that durable. This stuff is that durable. It protects you from the knife and the knife from everything else, right? So it's just, you know, it to me, it's a no-brainer. Kydex is a no-brainer. And it does take just as long to build a custom Kydex rig like this as it does to build a comprehensive leather rig. It takes just as much time, right? Only generally, we don't charge as much as the leather guys do because they got all that hand sewing to do, right? We don't have to hand sew anything. Even my Leather Elite series, which is leather, it's actually full grain leather over a fully functioning Kydex sheath system. I don't have any here because every one that I build is spoken for. It's already bought. So it doesn't stick around long. It goes out the door. Right? So I don't have any here. You can see them on the website, www.yellowhawkcustomkydex.com. There's several Leather Elite, full grain leather, over a fully functioning Kydex sheet. The best of both worlds. Right? And it really is the best of both worlds. Okay? So, I hope you guys enjoyed this discussion about leather versus Kydex. Leather's a great material, my opinion. Kydex is just better. It's a better material. And very practical. Very practical. Okay, guys. That's it for this video. This is Doug Wilson for Yellowhawk Customs Outdoors. Thanks for watching. My throat's still a little sore from being sick. I'll see you on the next video. Thank you.